Actor-turned-politician Kamal Haasan has opposed the inclusion of Bhagavad Gita in Anna University's syllabus. Kamal Haasan said that the students could decide on their own if they wanted to become a propagandist later in life. Pramod Madhav joining us live once again. So, Mr. Kamal Haasan probably has a point when he says that why impose these things, why have this kind of religious content in syllabus? Because if the students choose to study that kind of syllabus, they can always do that later in life. Tell us what exactly Kamal Haasan said and in what context.
Well, Kamal Haasan very clearly wants to mention, just like education activists, that the actual subject calls itself as psychology. And as per the Anna University Vice Chancellor, it's optional among three subjects. But apparently, as per the Anna University's website, it is compulsory carrying three credit scores for information science and technology undergraduate engineering students. So that's when it became contentious, because when we spoke to Vice Chancellor of Anna University, he explained, claiming that the actual syllabus contains psychology, like books on philosophy, the excerpts from Plato, Socrates, and various other things, and that's why he tried to include it. But however, the problem here is that you can call Bhagavad Gita at one end as a philosophical book, but at the same time, it's also a holy scripture. Kamal Haasan also trying to imply that, saying that if you need to Bhagavad Gita as compulsory for students, and you have to make various other books like Granth Sahib, Bible, Quran, everything. But he does not take the names of that. He simply says that those books should also be made compulsory. So that will not work. That's why he says that let the students study whatever that is required for the syllabus, and finishing which, if they want to become preachers or religious people, they would go ahead and choose what books they would like to study. That's why he's also backing certain educationists from the state who are not happy with Anna University's decision.
All right. So in that sense, now, has there been any response? Because it is one thing to indulge in this rhetoric and say you should not be doing this or that, but Mr. Kamal Haasan is not in power in Tamil Nadu. Is his advice being taken seriously? Will it have any bearing at all anywhere?
Well, after we brought this to the public's view almost 3 days back, the Vice Chancellor did speak to us. Mr. M.K. Surappa said that there was a mistake, and by miscommunication, instead of making philosophy as an optional subject, it was made compulsory. We did try to tell him that you cannot make an optional subject optional and provide that three credit scores, where which he said definitely amendments would be made and it will be changed. But no change has been done so far in the Anna University's website. He said since there is time until next year, the amendments will be very soon changed and you don't have to worry about anything. He did also say that he is giving us his word. The bigger problem educationists had with this issue is that no one has reading philosophy books under philosophy subject, but Bhagavad Gita is also considered as a holy script. So yes, that's where the problem comes. Actually, a holy book means you also have to bring various other religious holy books, and that is why it's still being contended.
Absolutely. One factor is the aspect of imposition, which other students of other religious communities may not be absolutely accepting of. And then, of course, the question of religious scriptures being included in syllabus. Bhagavad Gita, no one can deny, is a holy book. Thanks for joining us, Pramod, with your inputs.